just think, the power that rests in your hands, provided you make it work. A slip on the sidewalk is a small thing. It happens to me. A fall from a ladder is a small thing. That happens to me. The slip or the fall produces a subluxation, and that subluxation is a small thing. The subluxation produces pressure on the nerve, and that pressure is a small thing. And the pressure cuts off the flow of mental impulses, and that decreased flowing is a small thing. And that decreased flowing produces a diseased body, and that is a big thing for that man. And multiply that sick man by 1,000, and you control the physical and mental welfare of a city. Multiply that man by 1,000,000, and you shape the physical and mental destiny of a state. And multiply that man by 156 million, and you forecast and can prophesy the physical and mental stasis of a nation. So the slip or the fall, the subluxation, the pressure, the flow of mental impulses, and disease are big enough to control the thoughts and actions of a nation. And that's the power that rests with you. Now comes a man. Any one man, small thing. This man gives an adjustment, and that adjustment is a small thing. The adjustment replaces the subluxation, that's a small thing. And the adjusted subluxation releases pressure upon nerves, and that's a small thing. The released pressure restores health to a man, and that is a big thing to that man. Multiply that well man by 1,000, and you step up the physical and mental stasis of a city. Multiply that well man by 1,000,000, you increase the efficiency of a state. And multiply that well man by 156 million, and you have produced a healthy, wealthy, and better race for posterity. So the adjustment of the subluxation to release pressure upon nerves, to restore mental impulse flow, to restore health, is big enough to rebuild the thoughts and actions of the world. So the ideal that knows the cause, that can correct the cause of disease, is one of the biggest ideas I know.